Teron Armstead here of the New Orleans Saints. I'm here at Dookie Chase's, the world-famous restaurant and a staple in New Orleans. I'm here to talk about the history, the culture, the tradition, the Creole cuisine, everything. I'm excited. Let's go. Miss Stella, I have been in New Orleans for going on 8 years now, but have never been to this restaurant. I've heard a lot of great things about it. I heard a little bit about the history and the culture, but can you tell me more about it?
Oh, I'd love to. We've been around now for 79 years. Wow. Actually, we started off as a po'boy stand in 1939, and then in 1941, we opened into a restaurant. It was started by Emily and Edgar Chase Sr. And they started the restaurant because they loved the community. And of course, my grandmother felt she was the best cook around. And it came through my grandparents to my father, who was a musician at the time. Then in 1949, he met my mother. They were married and came into the restaurant business. So this was her opportunity to come in and make her changes and to change it into fine dining, because she felt that's what the African American community deserved and needed at that time.
I know the restaurant business is a pretty tough business to sustain, and you guys have been doing it for 79 years?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, that's amazing. Can you speak on what it takes to have that longevity?
Leah Chase, Chef Leah Chase, who we just recently lost in June, and she's a big loss to us because she had the personality that could reach out to everyone, and she was able to do what we want to continue to do, make everyone feel welcome at our restaurant.
What would you say was Miss Leah Chase's favorite dish?
Well, of course, she loved the gumbo. And she would always tell people her gumbo was the best. First time President Bush came was after Katrina. And of course, you know, we were in a bad way here in New Orleans. Mm-hmm. And he came to find out what he could do to make things better. And at that time, it was a lot of dignitaries meeting with him, the governor, the mayor, and mm-hmm. even Drew Brees actually came and was participating in that round table discussion. And they had gumbo, and she said, you know, we'll be able to solve all the problems over the bowl of gumbo.
That's powerful. That's yes. powerful. So you mentioned President Bush, Drew Brees. What are some other names that has been through these doors?
Okay. Well, of course, President Obama, and we were very happy to serve him the gumbo as well. He just made one little mistake and put hot sauce in Mrs. Chase's gumbo.
No, he did. No,
so
he did.
She got in trouble. He got in trouble. But he came, and he also had the fried chicken, so we've served him. But our history goes all the way back. We served the Freedom Bus Riders. Yeah. We were the only place that many African-American entertainers could come in the early 50s and the late 40s after they entertained, because of course integration hadn't happened.
Yeah.
So even though the entertainers could go and entertain everyone, they couldn't go everywhere to eat. And they would come here. So we served people like Nat King Cole, Lena Horne, Duke Ellington, Dizzy Gillespie, James Bowen. The list goes on,
wow.
Quincy Jones, the Jackson Five, and I tell the young people, even Beyonce and her husband, JC. So we've served quite a few,
yeah.
and many, many more that the list can go on and on. Till this day, I'm very thankful, as well as my whole family is thankful for the work that my grandparents and parents did, because they actually made it easier for us to come in. They were the ones who made our name what it is today. And we were able to just come in and try to sustain the work that they've done, which isn't easy, but we're trying hard to do it. And I'm a third generation, but we have a very strong fourth generation behind us. Mm-hmm. So I tell everybody, when you look at me, I know what you look at. Somebody's a little bit older and you may wonder what's up next. Well, we have a younger generation who is taking their place in the business now and helping us to make changes so that we can keep moving and improving.